So the people from the civil society and the activists gathered here at Press Club to show their, express their concerns over the arrest which was carried out by Maharashtra Police. We have Aruna Roy, activist. Ma'am, first of all, there's a question about the term itself, which is very much in the media, and as well as now the police have also started using it, urban Naxal. So what exactly do you think about this term?
Actually, they've coined this term, as they've coined many other terms, to damn ethical public protest, dissent, disagreement. And it's also very smartly done, because when you mention the word Naxal, it evokes ideas of violence and it evokes ideas of anti-state action. But the point is that they're just merely people who are using constitutional mechanisms to protest against injustice for the very poor, the marginalized, the Dalits, the Adivasis. So they don't want their voices to be amplified. Secondly, those voices are all against corporate interest. Right. So the corporate interest also is investing in it in one sense. Maybe not directly, but the government is definitely investing in it to silence any kind of obstruction, so far as they are concerned, to the progress of all development activities.
There are claims and comments and arguments that even during the Congress regime, rather the UPA too, the country witnessed similar kind of crackdown on the activist, be it Binayak Sen, right? The way he was handled, the entire case was handled. So what is new about
Binayak
this?
Was not under the UPA. Binayak was incarcerated by the BJP government in Chhattisgarh. It was during the UPA government, but I think it was not done by the UPA government. It was done by the BJP government in Chhattisgarh. There are other cases where they have filed cases against people like Uday Kumar in the south, in Kudankulam. Yeah, there have been. Not at this scale, not at this pitch, and not with this kind of propagation of labels, branding and media. This smacks of a toothpaste or a powder campaign. You know, it is not really a political act. And this government has been using advertisements, it's been using jingles, propaganda, all of it for their political campaigns. Now what this does is it really puts this whole issue into a realm of complete lack of political responsibility and that of political accountability.
One more question. Yesterday in the court, Delhi High Court, State Council as well as the Maharashtra Police had a really tough time, you know, handling the questions from Justice S. Muralidhar. The question was straightforward, that how the transit remand was, issued by the court. So in light of these developments, how do you see the police action, number one? And do you think that there's a hope from the legal justice system?
See, I think I have a lot of hope from the legal justice system as of today. But with the police, they have always been tools of the ruling establishment. What the ruling establishment wants, they do. So you have to see them in conjunction with the Maharashtra government.
One last question. There's a narrative on the social media about this particular round of arrest, that why this hue and cry, the police is doing its work. If there's a problem or the case is not valid, the court will go on to give justice to these people. How do you respond to such arguments?
I think that in the case of these people, definitely there's a strong message to civil society. So therefore, civil society will speak out. It's not just a mere matter of a crime, because there is no crime. Because when you fabricate things and you come up suddenly in a swoop, then you're really talking not to those five people. You're talking to the lakhs of people they represent, the hundreds of crores of people they represent, whom they bring to your notice, my notice. And of course, with me, they've worked with me in bringing my cases to your notice. So you're really constricting and constraining a huge numbers of this population of India from having any voice in statecraft, in policy, in representation, in asking for justice.
Thanks for speaking to News Laundry.
Thank you.